Hi, how are you? I'm glad that you are here with me, and I'm glad that you are here in a class with me. Your teacher, Elisha Elias Lomai, and I'm here for the class Health Principle in Physical Education. And today we're going to talk about alcohol and alcoholism. And in the background, I have five students. Wherever you are, can you shout, "Hello!"
Hello!
You can hear the sound. And in the background, we have five people. We have Mr. Mtango Tenga. We also have Miss Maria Mchelo. We also have Miss Naomi Pius. We also have Beatrice Daniel and Winnieli Mgonja. They'll be in the background, and at the end of class, they'll take time to wave to you and say hi. And join me as we move together. And this time we're talking about the topic is alcohol and alcoholism. So the first lecture number five, will be about alcohol. And the lecture number six will talk about alcoholism. You wonder, why do I have to differentiate alcohol and alcoholism? Are they the same thing? Is it the same thing? Or multiple things? When you talk of alcohol, we talk of a drink and the composition, what it does. When you talk of alcoholism, we talk about psychological and physiological dependence of a drink that con drinks that contain alcohol. So alcoholism is a disease and alcohol is a drink. Don't mix the two. They could be related, but they're not the same. And so join me as we move forward. Let's talk straight to that. Alcohol. Have you ever wondered what is alcohol? Alcohol is a product of carbohydrate produced by the process of fermentation. Alcohol is a drink, and alcohol is particularly a depressant. You know, there are so many types of drinks, but we don't have alcohol which is not a depressant. Alcohol as alcohol is a drink, okay, produced from carbohydrate. You can never have alcohol produced by protein. You can only have alcohol produced from carbohydrate. It could be sugar, it could be starch, it could be from fruits, from cereals, but a product of carbohydrate. So alcohol is a product of carbohydrate. But the only difference is that alcohol is a product of carbohydrates produced by a fermentation process. That is alcohol. Now, alcohol is a depressant. We have other kind of drinks that makes a person feel a bit excited, but alcohol is a depressant. It makes a person feel cool. No problem. So alcohol is a depressant. Being an alcohol, alcohol contains an intoxicating substance called ethyl alcohol or ethanol. So, being a drink, we don't have alcohol which is not a drink. We don't have it in solid form. That's not alcohol. So, alcohol is a drink that contains intoxicating substance called ethyl alcohol or ethanol. So, alcohol without ethyl alcohol or without ethanol, it's not alcohol. And it is that intoxicating substance within the alcohol that makes the alcohol itself. But unfortunately, alcohol is the most commonly used and commonly sold drug. Alcohol is a drug. You will say, "Who is a drug?" Yes, alcohol is a drug. You know, what is a drug? A drug is a substance that alters the way human body works. So, if your body should work this way and the drug makes you do something else, then that's a drug. If any substance that alters the way your body works, that's a drug. So, alcohol is a drug which alter the proper functioning of the body. And we will see how does that alter the function of the body as we proceed with the class. And Being a drug, this is the most commonly sold drug in the world. It is the most commonly sold in Africa, it's most commonly in Europe, in Asia, and other parts of the world, in America and elsewhere. It's one common drug that is sold, and it's one type of drug that is made locally. You'll be able to notice that alcohol is a product of carbohydrate produced by fermentation, as I noted before. You will notice that being a product of carbohydrate, every place with different people have different ways of which they make alcohol from their perspective. Those who have a lot of cereals like maize, they will have, you'll find a common alcohol made from maize. Like there in my area, Karatu Mbulu, they have a lot of maize, and you'll find that they have alcohol made from maize. They call it busa. If you travel to areas of Kigoma, a lake region where they have a lot of cassava, you find that they have alcohol made from cassava, because it has carbohydrate. If you go to areas with a lot of banana, like Moshi, Kilimanjaro, you'll find them having mbege, a brand, they call it mbege, which is made from banana and millet. Because that's a common product that is found there. If you go, to mention a few, if you go to the coastal region, you'll find another kind of alcohol made from coconut. They call it mnazi. And if you go to southern highlands, where they have a lot of bamboo, you have another alcohol made from bamboo. They call it ulanzi. If you go to different places, to Maasai land, they will have another product of alcohol made from honey, which is also another type of alcohol. Different society have different types of alcohol made from resources found in a given location. Even those my friends from Pare area, they also have their also special alcohol made from sugarcane. They call it dengelua. And those are just a few. If I could mention different products of alcohol from different area, you will notice that commonly different society make their alcohol from for those who want or who produce alcohol, they make it from products of carbohydrate that are commonly found in a given area. Even those from Dodoma, they have another one made from sorghum, and any many more. Now, when alcohol is when somebody takes alcohol, it's the most commonly used drug. But alcohol drinks vary in percentage of alcohol they contain. There's some alcohol drink which can have, 90%. Other would have 4% of alcohol. So they vary on percentage of alcohol. It is not a matter of how many bottles of a person has taken, but what percentage of alcohol in that drink that usually makes a person more drunk faster than the other. There are other factors. We're going to talk about that as we proceed. Now, we are here to understand alcohol as a product. And we cannot respond to alcoholism if we do not have a clear understanding of the drink itself. So alcohol drinks vary in percentage of alcohol. Now, absorption of alcohol. Once a person has consumed alcohol, alcohol is usually absorbed in the stomach and other parts of the gut. And once it's taken from there, a lot of changes will follow. It is carried around the body into the bloodstream. It is when the alcohol reaches the brain, the effects off, the alcohol are usually revealed. So once a person takes the alcohol, the alcohol does not go from a mouth to urination. There's no connection between the stomach and the urinary system. That connection usually goes through the bloodstream. You find that people, when people drink alcohol, they go urinate quite often. They feel like they are urinating alcohol. They are not urinating alcohol. They are rather, the alcohol is taken into the bloodstream, and more will be excreted in the future, and that's why they usually go for urination. As we proceed, you will understand much better. So, alcohol is carried around the bloodstream. From the stomach, it is absorbed in the small intestine into the bloodstream. So when the alcohol blood level goes high, then usually the person feel intoxicated. When alcohol is taken in the bloodstream, it reaches the brain. Now when alcohol reaches the brain, it affects the brain's activity. If the brain was functioning perfectly, the effects of alcohol into the brain is what makes a person feel the difference. When alcohol reaches the brain, some few things usually happens. First of all, when alcohol reaches the brain, it often makes a person feel relaxed and uninhibited. It is this feeling that makes people drink alcohol. When alcohol reaches the brain, it makes a person feel relaxed. And that's why we call alcohol a depressant. You know, there are some drugs like marijuana, in Swahili they call it bangi. They make a person feel high, feel active. But this one makes a person relaxed. But not only relaxed, the person feel uninhibited. That is to say, when a person drinks alcohol, what makes when the brain of a person receive alcohol, which was absorbed into the bloodstream, it makes a person relaxed and it makes a person feel uninhibited. And that's why you feel people will start to behave differently. They feel like no problem. There's nothing. You even see and feel that these people who have taken alcohol, even the speech usually changes because the person feels relaxed and uninhibited. Now, that's not enough, alcohol is naturally slowly broken down into harmless substance by the liver. The effect of alcohol, therefore, will usually gradually wear off. And that's why a person will take alcohol this moment. After a few hours or several hours, you see the person is no longer drunk because the liver breaks down alcohol into harmless substance. And the liver will break it down into harmless substance. And so the effects of alcohol will gradually wear off. And if a person drink alcohol, the faster the body absorb alcohol, the higher the alcohol blood level will be. The more alcohol in the blood, the greater the effect will be seen. So the absorption of alcohol is simply that the faster the body absorb alcohol, then the more or the higher the alcohol blood level. Once this alcohol has been absorbed much faster, more alcohol will be in the blood. And more alcohol in the blood, more alcohol level will be there. And so the brain will be impacted with more alcohol, and so the person will seem more drunk. So what makes a difference? Have you ever asked yourself that why is it that some people they'll take one bottle, half a bottle, they're completely drunk. And others will brag themselves, I can drink the whole crate and I'll not feel drunk. Why is it that some people will be more drunk faster than the other? There are some variation. Let's talk about them. A person become drunk more quicker when they drink, when a person drinks with an empty stomach. That's one thing. The person becomes drunk much faster when they drink with an empty stomach. And you will notice that that people who drink alcohol, in the beginning they usually value eating food, but later in the alcoholism stage three, they usually do not eat that much. Or they don't give priority into eating as well, and because they can't get drunk very fast. A person become drunk more quicker when they drink with an empty stomach. That's first thing. Another thing, a person becomes drunk much faster, much quicker when they drink or they add fizzy mixture. They have taken vodka, they have taken konyagi, they have taken safari, Kilimanjaro, Bia Bingwa, Plisna, and all those kind of mixed drinks. They drink, they usually become drunk more quicker. No wonder people usually get drunk faster or more in the party. Because here you have given this kind of drink, and there you have given the other kind of drink. Oh, no wonder people usually get more drunk when they are just given offers to drink, rather than those who you buy for on their own. Because when a person add fizzy mixture, mix of different types of drink, they usually get drunk much quicker. The other thing is that if a person drink quickly. They usually get drunk much faster than if they drink it slowly. No wonder that some people will be bragging themselves, I can drink a lot and I'm not getting drunk. They don't get drunk because they usually drink slowly. Okay? Those who drink quickly usually get drunk faster than those who drink slowly. And then people usually also get drunk when they are small. And that's why it's not allowed to sell alcohol to people under age. Unfortunately, these advertisements of different company usually tell us that they advertise with a lot of, they'll put a lot of words, a lot of investment in advertising a brand. But when it comes to effects and these things to take precaution, they usually say quicker. You'll find that they will advertise with a lot of good words and of most promising words. But when it comes to effects or warning from people who are underage, they don't give much emphasis like that. So a person usually become more drunk when they are small, when they are also young. You find a person with 90 kilograms and a person with 45 kilograms, they can't, if they take the same type of bottle, one will be more drunker than the other, when the smaller one will be more drunk quicker than the other one who is not. And unfortunately, there's a bad thing that female are more also drunk quicker than male, and that is a problem. And you can notice that more female are usually in disadvantageous position than male, when they usually take the same amount of alcohol on the same given time period of time. So six things here. A person become more drunk quicker when they drink in an empty stomach. They have mixed of drink. They drink quicker. They are small. They are younger. or they are female. That should not make you as a male say, oh yeah, I now can drink. No. We all, if we take alcohol, everyone can get drunk. And everyone can be get intoxicated with alcohol. Now, there are some effects of alcohol. Some effects of alcohol are short-term and others are long-term. So let's go to some short-term effects. Some short-term effects of alcohol. One is poor reaction time. If this is the thing, and I'm going to throw it to you. A person who is drunk cannot be able to catch it because it will be very difficult for him or her to catch it because he or she see it coming, but reacting on time becomes a problem. Because one of the effects of alcohol in the brain is poor reaction time. The time between when you see the item until you react is a challenge, that there's poor reaction time. And that's why they say don't drink and drive. Because a person will brag that I can drink and drive, even if I cannot be able to walk, just take me to my vehicle, I can drive home safely. If something comes in front of you, you cannot react timely as equivalent to a person who has not who is not drunk. The other effect of alcohol in your brain is that it's poor muscle control and coordination. Poor muscle control and coordination. And you are seeing this coming, if I'm going to throw it to you, but you cannot be able to control your muscles and coordinate to catch it. And so that usually it's due to the effect of alcohol in the brain, in the spinal cord, and other parts of the nervous system. The other short-term effect of alcohol is poor judgment when making decision. You cannot make proper decision if you're making a choice or judgment under the influence of alcohol. And so, those are some of short-term effects of alcohol. Short-term effects of alcohol. There are some long-term abuse of alcohol, some effects of alcohol, long-term effects of alcohol. We all have hangover. A person will have hangover. Those short-term effects that I've been talking about, poor reaction time, poor muscle control and coordination, poor judgment. Once a person is drunk, the person can experience those three effects. But when the person is not drunk, the effects are not there. Once a person is out of the drink and it's not there in the bloodstream, you find that now the reaction time, there's not poor anymore. It's not poor anymore. Muscle control, it's perfect. Judgment will be made perfect. But some long-term effects, this will still prevail even after the alcohol levels goes down. Hangover. A person will get hangover. The effect that usually a person feels after taking alcohol, even after the alcohol is over. It is that hangover which makes some people, or more people, go back and take a drink early in the morning. Weight gain. A person will add up weight. But be cautious with this. Later on, they usually lose weight. In the beginning, they usually add weight. Weight gain is another effect. Another effect is high blood pressure. It's another long-time effect of alcohol. The other effect is depressed immune system. Alcohol also is related to some types of cancers. Cancer. Alcohol is also related to liver diseases and liver problem. There's another effect of alcohol poisoning. Another effect of alcohol is heart and respiratory failure. Another effect of alcohol, which is also long time, is loss of appetite. Another effect is vitamin deficiency. Another effect of alcohol, which is very serious, memory loss. So those are some of long-term effects. There are also other effects, we can talk about them. Alcohol in the heart and blood muscles, blood vessels. Let's talk part to part. In short-term, if short-term effects of alcohol in the heart and blood vessels, in short-term, alcohol has some effects. That is, respiration usually increase and the skin becomes flushed. It is this effect that you can see and tell the difference between a person who has taken a drink and a person who has not taken a drink. You can always see that the skin becomes flushed. It's like the skin becomes smooth and shining, and there's a difference in comparison to a person who has not taken alcohol. The skin becomes flushed and respiration usually increase. The person feels different. This is short-term effect on the heart and the blood vessels. But in long term, there's a risk of high blood pressure and the damage to the heart muscles, the blood vessels. Okay? So, in long-term effect of alcohol, in the heart and blood vessels, the blood pressure is a problem, damage to heart muscles, and the blood vessels are usually hardened and become less flexible. But alcohol has also effects in other parts of the body, in the brain, in the nervous system, In short term, the speech becomes slurred and difficult in walking. The person cannot be able to speak as freely as I'm talking here. The speech becomes slurred. If I'm going to tell one statement with my normal speech and the other statement with the slurred speech, if I say wewe vipi, mambo yako yanakwendaje, it's like I'm saying, how are you, how are your things going. If I'm using that, I'm talking the same thing with the slurred speech for you to understand. Wewe vipi, mambo yako yanaendaje. The speech is there, is slurred. You can see the difference. Now, in short term, usually a person will have a speech slurred. This is due to the impact of alcohol. And that's why you find drunks, people who are drunk, almost speak the same. Mamba vipi bwana, temana na mimi bwana, nasemaje. The speech becomes slurred. And in long term, before I go for that, even in walking is also a challenge to a person who has taken alcohol. The balance is a problem and difficult in walking. You find they make steps back and forth, left and right. They try to find balance. But in long term, in the brain, there are some effects of alcohol in the brain. In the brain, in long term, cells are usually destroyed. Don't brag yourself that you drink every day and there's no problem. There's a challenge there. The challenge is the brain cells are usually destroyed. And unfortunately, once destroyed, they are unable to be replaced. In long-term effects, we are talking about brain cells are destroyed and unable to be replaced. But also, alcohol damage has damage to nerves in the body and resulting to numbness in hands and feet. So those are some of the effects of alcohol in the brain and nervous system. But also alcohol has some effects in the liver. In the liver, the liver usually can oxidize alcohol, but one serving of alcohol in an hour. There's no way to speed up this process until the liver has had enough time to oxidize alcohol into other form. The alcohol usually keeps circulate in the bloodstream. Now, there's no way to speed up the liver. So usually liver can oxidize the alcohol, but the speed cannot be increased. It usually can be able to oxidize one serving of alcohol an hour. So you cannot speed up that. Now, what are the effects of alcohol in the liver? In a short time, the effect of alcohol in the liver will be as follows, that the liver changes alcohol into water and carbon dioxide. However, in long term, the liver is usually damaged. The liver is usually damaged, resulting into liver cirrhosis. This is usually a scarring in the liver and the destruction of a liver itself. The other effects of alcohol is fatty liver. The liver, fatty liver, alcohol interferes with the blood, interferes with the body's ability to break down fat. And so the excess fat blocks the flow in the liver, resulting to reduced oxygen, and the cells usually die. This can be reversed when a person stops drinking. There's a hope for you. If you are drinking alcohol, you can be having a problem of a fatty liver. That is to say, alcohol interferes with the ability of the body to break down fat, and so the liver becomes or has fat. You have fatty liver. Now, fatty liver reduced oxygen level in the liver and other parts of the body. And so the challenge is, this can cause death of cells. It can kill some cells, so many cells in the body. But this process, this is the good news. If you are drinking, if you stop drinking and choose a better, perfect way of life, this process can be reversed if a person stops drinking. Now, take a break. When we come back, we will proceed with other effects of alcohol and I'll be back. Take a break. And when we come back, we'll review and finish the rest of the part, and we'll be back. Hello. Okay, welcome back. Welcome back. We are after. I'm sure you have taken a break, and in the previous part, we discussed a few things from the alcohol itself as a drink. What makes an alcohol? We also talked about different things. What makes a person more drunker than the other? In the end of this, we'll have a quick revision and we'll have a discussion with friends who are here in this class, and you cannot miss them. We have 5 people in the room, and we'll discuss together different concepts of alcohol and alcoholism, and you cannot wait. So as we were talking, is that One of the effects of alcohol is fatty liver. Alcohol interferes with the body's ability to break down fats, and so excess fat usually blocks the flow in the liver, resulting into reduced oxygen and the cells die. But the good news is that if you stop drinking, the process can be reversed. You need to stop drinking before it's too late, if you are to stop, and I hope you can. But let's proceed. The liver cirrhosis is another effect of alcohol. Liver cirrhosis is the scarring of a liver. The blood flows in the scar area. Usually there's no blood flow in the scar, that usually caused in the liver as the liver struggle to break down alcohol. It can cause or can have liver cirrhosis. Those are like spots within the liver. These are scars in the liver. The blood is not able to flow in the area with that scar. The liver can, and since the liver cannot function normally, the symptom of liver cirrhosis is that high blood pressure, abdominal swelling, and jaundice. This is usually irreversible. I told you that fatty liver can be reversed, but liver cirrhosis cannot be reversed. That's very unfortunate. That once a person has scarring in the liver, they can only manage, but they cannot remove the scar. Don't think that if you drink for 20 years and you have liver cirrhosis, then stopping drinking today will remove all the scars. The earlier you stop drinking, the better for your own health. Make the right choice. Okay, there are some effects of alcohol in the stomach and pancreas. You know, we are talking about these effects of alcohol as per area. In the stomach and pancreas, in short term, the stomach acid increases, which is often resulting to in nausea and vomiting. And that's what makes people, after drinking alcohol, some people usually vomit, because the stomach acid usually increase. That is a short-term effect, because the acid secreted in the stomach usually increases. You know, our stomach has several secretions, but one of those is hydrochloric acid, which is usually secreted. It is natural that the stomach has to be in acidic condition so as to support the digestion. But when a person drink alcohol, the level of acid usually increase, which creates nausea and vomiting. But in long term, the irritation occurs in the stomach lining, causing the open sores called ulcers, or pancreas becomes inflamed. So in the pancreas becomes inflamed, and in the stomach, the irritation can make stomach lining to have open sores, which are called stomach ulcers. There could be other causes of stomach ulcers, not necessarily alcohol, but that alcohol can also contribute. But another thing that we need to talk about is about alcohol poisoning. A sign of alcohol poisoning is mental confusion, coma, inability to be excited, vomiting, and seizures. Those are signs of alcohol poisoning. Slow respiration is another thing. Hypothermia, dehydration, and irregular heartbeat. Those are signs of alcohol poisoning. So alcohol poisoning is also common. I'm sure there must be some safe amount of alcohol in the body? Can you have you ever asked yourself, what is the safest amount of alcohol to drink? The safest amount of drink is usually zero. Hello? Everyone, hello?
Hello?
The safest amount of drink is no drinking. This is at any age to anyone. If you want the safe amount of drink, that is zero. That means no drink is more safer, is the safest rather than drinking. So we are taking a break straight from the presentation and turning to the discussion. And in the discussion, we'll bring my friends here and we'll talk together about different aspects. Thank you very much. Let's go for a discussion. Oyo!
Oyo!
Okay. So let's go for discussion. Your name, please?
Winnie Mgonja.
We have Winnie Mgonja. Over there, we have another one.
Beatrice Daniel.
We have another lady over there.
Naomi Pius.
We have another lady over there.
Mariam Chelo.
We have another gentleman over there.
Mtango Tenga.
So we have four ladies and one gentleman for the students. And we are two gentlemen here, one teacher and one student. We have four ladies in the house. And we are going to talk about a few things that we covered today together. And one other thing is alcohol. What is alcohol? If I'm to ask, what is alcohol? Someone to answer that, please. Yes.
The product of carbohydrate.
Uh-huh.
Produced by fermentation process.
So alcohol is a product of carbohydrate produced by fermentation process. Can you clap for her, please? Okay, I will only clap once, and after that we will only move forward. Okay, let's move on. Something else that I need us to talk. Tenga,
yes.
Tell me, what are the factors that makes a person, can you give me one factor which makes a person being drunk more quicker than the other?
It is when he or she drinks in an empty stomach.
So if a person drink with an empty stomach, definitely the person will be more drunk more quicker than the other.
Yes.
Mariam, another factor, please. When they are small, when they are young, another factor, Winieli.
Female
are more drunk, they get drunk faster than male. And tell me, Miss Naomi, is there any factor which makes a person more drunk faster than the other?
Yes.
What is that?
When
they have a different mixture. When you drink vodka, konyagi, safari, you mix the beers, spirits, whiskey, wine, all those are having alcohol. So if a person drink a mixture of drinks, then they get drunk more quicker. And a drug is any substance that alters the way a human body works. Can you tell me another drug? Give me an example, apart from alcohol. Anything that can change the human body, the way it works? Anyone who can help? Eh?
Konyagi.
Konyagi is a type of an alcohol. It's a spirit. Uh-huh.
Tobacco.
Tobacco also can change the way the body works. You can see that the body usually works differently when a person has taken tobacco or smoke cigarette. Now, if you check on alcohol, this is the most commonly sold drug. Now, Can you tell me one of the effect? Anyone to tell me at least one effect or the other of alcohol? We'll move from one. Tenga,
yes.
Tell me one of the effect of alcohol.
Yeah, one of the effects of alcohol is that there's a poor reaction time when there's the poor reaction time anticipation is so low.
Okay, poor reaction time. This is very important. Can you clap for the gentleman, please? Thank you. Poor reaction time. That's a problem. That's an effect of alcohol. Another effect of alcohol, Maria.
Poor judgment when making decision.
Poor judgment when you make decision. When a person make a decision under the influence of alcohol, hello,
yes.
That's a problem. You know, there are so many children who are born because parents got they got conception simply because they never planned to have a conjugal act. They never knew each other but one was drunk and they met with a stranger. They had sex because they made poor judgment,
yes.
And they usually call that an accident. Do you think that's an accident?
Yes.
Hello. So poor judgment when making decision. That's another effect of alcohol. And the next person, can you give me another effect of alcohol?
Hangover.
That the head of a person who has taken alcohol last night, the following morning, is usually painful, banging. Discomfort, nuisance, and all those kind of things, nausea and vomiting, that's a hangover.
Mm.
And as we move on, can you give me another effect?
Weight gain.
Weight gain. They usually gain a lot of weight. Mm-hmm. Winnieli, can you give me another effect?
Blood pressure.
High blood pressure. So, ladies and gentlemen, wherever you are, you can move with us as we are winding up. You can see that we had a wonderful class and we were talking about alcohol and its effect. In the next class, we are going to talk about something else. And lecture six, we are going to talk about alcoholism. And that is something else, something different. Alcohol and alcoholism are not the same. Where alcohol is the drink, alcoholism is a disease. A disease is anything that alters the body. And alcoholism, we'll talk about that. Alcoholism is a disease. And it has three stages. In the coming class, we'll even learn from when a person starts to learn to drink until when the drink takes him or her. We'll follow that trend and you'll learn that if you are drinking alcohol, you are in which stage? There are three stages, by the way. I should not go for that class. It is very interesting for you to learn about that because it's helpful to you. And not only that, it will be also helpful to you teaching others about alcohol and alcoholism. We have only covered the alcohol as a drink. Next, it will be alcoholism as a disease. Thank you very much. I am Elisha Elias Loma, your teacher, and we were together with these wonderful people, Winnieli
Mgonja, Beatrice Daniel,
Naomi Pius,
Mariam Chelo,
Mtango Tenga. Can you all say Oyo?
Oyo!
Thank you very much.